Fight number 9, win number 9, and your first little belt.
Just to start.
Very, very impressive performance, mate. You started really, really fast and took control of the fight. And the fight was basically won inside those first 4 rounds.
Yeah. Well, my original plan was to start slow. But within 10 seconds, I just tapped him with my jab. I knew I could catch him, so why start slow when I can get rid of him?
So, well, did you put him down heavy in the 4th round, was it?
I think it's 4th. Put him down. And then, it was 8. Then again, 8 and twice again.
Mm-hmm.
I knew I would catch him. It's very awkward with it. As soon as I jab him, it was countering. So I figured that went out within on the 4th round or 5th round.
So I think he had to adapt quite a lot in there.
Yeah,
he changed from his normal style inside the first round. He really had to change because he just seemed to be finding his range quite quickly. And you know, like I say, it looked like it was going one way. But I must admit, I give Ashley credit. After he'd gone down, it looked like quite a heavy knockdown in the 4th round or 5th round, I'm not sure which. But he sort of began to turn the fight and you took your foot off the pedal a little bit. And I thought, ooh, hang on, could this change a little bit?
It wasn't foot off the pedal, I started off so fast, it seemed like I was slowing down, but I wasn't. I was just figuring him out. So I wanted him to come forward because it was just one-way traffic. I'm really going forward, forward, forward. So I thought, let him come to me, he'll lead onto it. And that's what had to happen. He got sloppy because he thought I was getting tired. I just catched him with the right hand. Like I said, always be alert. I'm always ready. Even Klitschke's, everything. When we're hugging, I'm always ready.
Well, you know what I wanted? I wanted it to be a good fight. Mm-hmm. And I say it was a very one-sided fight early on. Mm-hmm. But I give him credit. He dug himself, you know, he dusted himself off, got back up, and gave you a bit of a good go. Mm-hmm. But then you turned the fight around. Was it in the 7th round then, was it? Or the 8th round, was it?
8th, last round. I knew I had to put him away because at a level, I'm stopping this kid. Not being cocky or anything, I just knew I was the levels above him. Obviously, I needed a good performance just to show my class.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm gonna beat him, just you know, on points, you know, it shows I'm not above the level. I wanna move up the rankings. You know what I mean? So I have to get a good performance.
What does that mean then for you now? What are you looking at?
I want Century Edit title.
Yeah.
I want the belt.
Century. I think that's one of our lads in
Ryan. We were originally gonna fight for that, but he got it before me.
Mm-hmm.
I want to fight him next. That's it. Simple.
Right, another unbeaten kid.
Another unbeaten kid. He's 9-2 KOs. I'm 9-3 KOs. Similar on the paper, but we'll see. You know, if he's willing to take the fight on, that's why I rate Ashley Payton. He's like me. He'll fight anyone. Let's see if Ryan will step up to the plate now.
Oh, well, listen. I'm glad you both delivered anyway. You both put on a great fight there. I say you started absolutely red hot, mate. It was phenomenal. And you're finishing it the way you started, so hats off to you, mate.
Thank you very much, Lee. Thank you.
Well done, mate.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.